Hello everyone, I'm Kiana. Hope you're having a nice weekend. Today I'm in the Yantou Asian village. My husband and I wanted to visit this village as recommended by a photographer. Now I'm so excited because it's my first time to see this type of well-preserved buildings of Qing Dynasty. I can't wait to go around now.
So it's a little windy, but I could better enjoy the scenery along the road. This is the archway of Yantou Asian village. It's totally made by stone with traditional Chinese hand carving. On the left side is a stone tapestry, which is used to introduce the location, famous landscape, celebrities, and development status of this village. As now is summer season, the sound of the cicadas is too loud and is a bit noisy. So according to the introduction, Yantou Asian village was formed in 3070 and is about 650 years old. It has been listed as one of the top 10 most beautiful Asian villages in Ningbo city. Yantou village is located in Xikou Town, Fenghua District of Ningbo. It has a distance of 50 kilometers away from Ningbo downtown. It takes about 48 minutes by driving car from Ningbo downtown to get here. Currently, it has 892 rural households with a population of 2,426. The surname of Yantou Asian village is Mao. Mao has a long and deep roots here. So Yantou has celebrities related to Mao Zedong, Mao Fumei, Mao Zedong, and Mao Bangchu. Here is the Qingyang Bridge, and under the bridge is the Shanxi River. Shanxi River has nurtured generations of people of Xikou Town, and Yantou Asian Village is located in the upper reaches of the Shanxi River, which winds through the whole village. Here is the cultural corridor of Yantou Village. On the left side is the Shanxi River, and on the right side is a small bamboo grove. I feel very cool when I walk into the corridor. Here is the introduction of the Yantou Asian Village. So let's check it. It says that the Yantou Village is the reading place of Chiang Kai-shek, and also is the home of Mao Fumei. Mao Fumei is the first wife of Chiang Kai-shek and the mother of Chen Qingguo. Yantou Village living the Republic on many of the side seas. So here has been raining so much this day. It's very humid. It should be mountain spring. The water is so clear. There is the Guangji Bridge ahead. In Chinese, it means Guangji Qiao. It was built in the Tongzhi period of Qing Dynasty. It is a typical stone arch bridge in the south of the Yangtze River, more than 130 years old. Guardian lions are a traditional Chinese architectural ornament, typically made of stone. They are also known as stone lions or shi shi. Then we climb to the top of the mountain and to overlook the whole village. We find a dragon temple on the hillside. The roof is designed with glazed tiles and carved with dragons. Do you know who they are? The four characters in the middle. They are the dragon kings or the four seas in Chinese fairy tales. In Chinese, it means that 四海龙王. The rightmost is the god of wealth. Chinese is 财神. The leftmost is the god of land. Chinese is 土地神. The green dragon king is Ao Guang in East Sea. Red dragon king is Ao Qing in South Sea. Black dragon king is Ao Shun in North Sea. And the white dragon king is Ao Ren in West Sea. So they protect the East, South, West, North Seas respectively. They are the dragon gods responsible for the crime. All the dragon kings can call on the wind and rain according to the requirements, which is equivalent to the god of weather. These are candlesticks and incense burners. And these are always set out in the temple in China here. My husband is out of breath because he hasn't climbed the mountain for so long. Finally, we arrive at the top of this mountain. So we can see that Yantou village is surrounded by mountains, and the Shanxi River flows through the whole village. Now we are in the entrance of Yantou village. The river is so clean that you can wash clothes directly. We are going to walk to the central location of this village. Here looks like an old building. is the old house of Mao Bangchu, and now as a heritage conservation of Ningbo. Mao Bangchu was a high-ranking military officer in the Chinese Chiang Kai-shek government. Here is the Qiantan Temple. These are the carving patterns, and all are the weapons from Chinese fairy tales. And we also have a TV series. The name of the TV is Legend of the Eight Immortals. This is a Asian costume mix TV cooperative produced by Singapore and China. Some of the shops are closed. Now we are in the middle of the village, and here is the Yongming Bridge. Under the bridge is the Shanxi River. It has been raining for the last 2 weeks, so the river has very quick flow speed, and the sound of the river becomes much louder. On the left side of the riverbed, we can see a long corridor. Normally, it's designed for leisure. People can sit in the corridor to have a chair and sightseeing. So there is a drain. I think the water flows down from the mountain. So this is the Shanxi River. In the past, the land transportation was not developed here. Because of the Shanxi River, the villagers could use the bamboo raft to carry goods and material. My husband is washing his hands. Now we are going inside to look at the design of the buildings. And here is the East street of Yantou. It used to be the business street. The local people said that during the period of the Republic of China, there were many shops and business, and more than 40 shops, villages were having business related with Chinese medicine, ironware, meat shops, and bingo shops. It can be called the number one street in the southwest area of Fenghua District. The water of the Shaanxi River is super green. There are plenty of espresso granules. Across the river is the West Street. Let's look at both sides of the river from the middle location. My husband is buying drinks. He has a few videos for a long time and sweat blow out all over his body. Many of the buildings here are made of stone foundation because in the southern China, we got lots of rainy days in summer season and people live near the river, so it's easy to get them. And stone foundation will be more solid, not easy to crash, and the stone dry is conducive to drainage and ventilation.
So here is the formal residence of Chen Sicheng. Chen Sicheng is the teacher of the Chongkaishe. So look at this. It says that former residents of Mao Zedong ancestor.
Mao Zedong began to set up school hall in Yantou Village. In 1899, he was a scholar.
来看一下。
It's totally built with the wooden material.
走嘛，走前面去，我们这小巷走一圈嘛。这棵树什么树？它上面有果。你看上面那不是果吗？对，没见过。
上面那个果，你看，这可以看到那个果很清楚。
It's so amazing. A small pool here, and already is washing dishes. This lawn is covered with moss, and green leaves are growing. Part of the line has fallen off. Here is a small and beautiful garden, so farmers can pick fresh vegetables from their garden. A small bamboo forest. Bamboo is very common in Fenghua. Bamboo shoes are a specialty, which are available all year round. We have just came out from the East Street. Now is the time after dinner. Some of the elderly are getting together and chatting. You may find that in most villages of China, many of the people living there are the elderly and children, because young people already went out to work and live in the downtown. For young people, they can have more job opportunities in the city. And elderly people love to live in hometown rather than go to a big city to live together with their son or daughter. Compared with the city, the elderly are more familiar with the life of their hometown, so they feel more relaxed and secure. In China, we have an idiom to describe it, that is, 落叶归根. It means that falling leaves return to their roots. We are now standing on the west side of the Shanxi River. The buildings in the east side are getting old, while the buildings on the west side are modern style. This is because most of buildings in east side are constructed in Qing Dynasty. As a kind of cultural heritage, the local government still preserves these ancient buildings cannot be destroyed. So local people will not demolish these ancient buildings for reconstruction. So there is lots of space in the west side. New buildings are allowed to be constructed here. This is all our journey today. If you have any feedback or opinions about our video, please feel free to leave us a comment below. We will have more videos on our countryside, culture, historical relics, food recipes, and real lifestyle in rural China. Thank you for watching.